So hi and what's up everyone, this is Saurav here from Delish Chai Shailish, and sorry for the late upload because I was quite busy with my interviews and I had gone to Bombay as well. So as requested, I'm going to share top 5 tips as a food blogger. So I'll start with the first one. I don't know, a lot of you are food bloggers or not, but then this video is specifically for the food bloggers. And the first tip which I would share is that whenever you are blogging or whenever you're writing about something, you need to have a genuine content. You need to have your honest opinion, because people are following you for what you experience and what your opinion is about a particular place. So always try to maintain the integrity and try to be as much as honest as possible, because people really appreciate that. So there are a lot of bloggers in the market who are writing anything and everything just because they're getting paid. But I would strongly recommend that you should have your own opinion. And so this is the first tip which I just wanted to share. The second tip would be, whenever you go to a particular place, don't just judge the place just by one experience or just by eating 2 items of the place. When I was a reviewer, I used to do that, honestly. So I have been to that place, so I would just say that a place has got multiple items to offer, but just because of 2 items which you didn't like, you would start judging the place is not suffice. It requires a lot of other things like food quality, quantity, hospitality, how the overall service is, how the overall ambience is. So always, whenever you start your journey as a food blogger, you should have a holistic experience. You should judge the place altogether, like not just with maybe just eating the food and eating 2 items and saying that it is not good or it is bad and just judging the place haywire. Judging the place up and down. So I would say, as a food blogger, your responsibility is quite more. So be responsible, guys. Be responsible, because a lot of people are following your opinion and you would not like to mislead them. The third thing is, I've seen a lot of food bloggers, they don't carry their own personal card. Just like if you want to be a professional food blogger, I would recommend that you should carry your own personal card, and whenever you hand it over to the particular person, it feels very professional, and they would look at you in the other way, because a lot of people don't carry their card. So this is like a bonus tip which I'm gonna give it to you, because if you have your own card and if you hand it over to them, they feel that this person is actually responsible, this person is more like a professional person who's actually taking his profession seriously. If you are a professional food blogger, even if you are not a professional food blogger, as a passionate food blogger who writes on his personal blog, you should definitely, I think, have a card. So this is the third tip which I want to talk about. And the fourth tip which I want to say is that be creative, guys. Like, do something which everyone else is not doing, but that doesn't mean that you just don't focus on your content. You need to have quality content as well. So you need to maintain 2 things, like you have to be creative as well as you need to maintain that quality content for which people are following you. And the last and the most important thing is that you should always have a disclaimer. Like, if you are going to visit the restaurant as a customer, then you should write that unbiased review based on my eating experience. Or if you are called for promoting a particular place, or if they pay you to write reviews, you just write over there that this is a sponsored post, but you did not necessarily mention how much they paid you or something like that. But then you need to definitely mention that it is more of a promotional content. And I would also say that just because you're getting money, it doesn't mean you should promote every kind of content which comes to you. And as I was late, I'll give a bonus tip to all of you guys. The last tip is that you need to collaborate. Saying that you need to collaborate with the like-minded people having the same interest which you have. So people who have the same interest which you have, you should definitely go ahead and collaborate with them on particular terms, because that will help both of you and you're going to reach to a higher audience. So that's all I want to say, and I'm really sorry once again for such a delayed upload, but I couldn't help it. I was quite busy with my family stuffs and even interviews. So however, I'm gonna try my level best to, you know, give daily updates on YouTube, because I'm quite enjoying it. So thanks a lot for supporting everyone, and thanks a lot for watching, guys. See you soon. Signing off. Oh yes, the most important thing which I wanted to say is that whenever you are going for any promotional articles or promotional content, you're not selling your opinion. Please remember that you're charging for your conveyance, your time, your efforts, and you're not charging for your opinion, because your opinion is not of such a low value. Please remember that you are a food blogger, so it's a respectable thing. So please maintain that your opinion should not be sold, guys. Please remember that there are thousands of people, thousands of audience who are watching you, who are following you daily, and please remember that you have to do justice to them also. So thanks a lot, everyone. I hope all of you have a good time. Signing off, guys.